glad that you guys have come in today because we do a lot of the photography on the road show, but I've got to tell you, in the times that I've been with the road show, these are the best stereographs that I've seen. Joan, these are yours on the right-hand side. Tell me a little bit about where you got them.
My husband was a Civil War buff, and he bought them. And I cannot say if it was a yard sale or an antique shop.
But it was some time ago then.
About 25 years ago.
25 years ago. And, yeah. And I assume that he's deceased now. So he didn't really tell you too much more about him.
No.
Well, let me tell you what you've got here. You've got a fantastic group of Civil War stereo views. You know, at the beginning of the Civil War, Matthew Brady was one of the first photographers to go out and photograph battlefield scenes. And he brought back these photographs to New York City and Washington, D.C. that shocked the public. For example, of the dead Civil War soldier. This was the first time that photographs had been used to depict dead people in the war. And this was an incredibly shocking thing. He began in the beginning of the war to issue stereo views of the war himself, but very quickly he ran into financial difficulty, and he turned to a New York company called E&HT Anthony to retail these stereo views. They purchased the negatives from Brady and then issued a whole series of photographic history, The War for the Union. What you've got here is probably one of the nicest collections that I've seen of these cards in a long, long time, including not only photographs of dead soldiers, but important personalities in the war. Any idea who this guy was?
Yes. He's the fellow who shot Booth, who killed Lincoln, and that's the one that really intrigued me the most, really
did. That's correct. That's Sergeant Boston Corbett.
Uh-huh.
That's the first time I've ever seen a stereo view of Boston Corbett.
Oh.
It's a great, great stereo view. These are all hand-tinted, and the photographic studio that was publishing these views had colorists that would sit in the back room with these stereo views, and they would take with a little paintbrush, hand-paint the colors on each one of these pictures. And the tinting that they did in these particular examples is much better than you normally see in this sort of genre of stereograph. Mark, I know that you're somewhat of a stereo view collector, so you've been sort of picking these up for some time. Tell me about your little collection that you've got here.
Well, I grew up in Pennsylvania, so I collected Pennsylvania views, and I found these over time. They just were wonderful images of Mark Twain, Walt Whitman, Bret Hart, Josh Billings, and Charles Dickens.
Yeah, these are great images that were produced by a New York photographer named Joshua Gurney. He took a whole series of celebrity portraits, and you've got some of the rare portraits that he did. The Twain view is a very fine view of Twain. The Whitman is a very rare portrait. Any idea between you two what these things are worth?
I have no idea.
Joan,
absolutely.
Your collection is worth between $5,000 and $7,000, and Mark, you have a few less, but you have quality views here. They're probably worth between $1,200 and $1,700 for the views you've got here.
Great.
Great bunch of stuff, and thanks for bringing them in.
Thank you. That's exciting.
They're really the best stereo views that I've seen in 2.5 years.
My husband would have been delighted.
Well, I'm happy to hear that.
Yeah.
He had a good eye.
Yeah, he really did.
Ha ha.